Hey guys, and welcome back to a brand new Tower Heroes video. As you've seen from the title, or maybe you are in the Pixelbit Discord, you have seen that daily quests, or let's just say quests in general, are coming to Tower Heroes. Now, first off, I have gotten a lot of messages saying, Bowie, your suggestion for quests came in the game, and I want to clear something up right away. This is not my suggestion for quests. As you remember from my video, features and improvements I would like to see in Tower Heroes Part 2, you know that my quest system is rotating quests, and this quest system is daily and weekly quests. And I really want to go over the differences and the negative aspects and the positive aspects of both. Starting off with my idea of the quests, aka rotating quests. So, what a rotating quest is: when you log into the lobby, you get one quest and one quest only. This can be anything from beating a one-star map, killing 50 goblins, you name it. Once you complete the quest, you get the coins and you get a randomly generated new quest. You complete that quest and you get a new quest. And this goes on forever, endlessly. Because it is endlessly and you can do it 24/7, the coin reward wouldn't be too high and the coins of every map would be nerfed. But overall, you would still get more coins than normal. That was my idea for quests. The reason why I suggested that is because the game right now needs a lot more replayability and just needs a reason for players to stick around longer. Okay, let's talk about the method that the developers chose, the daily and weekly quest system. So the difference with a daily and weekly quest system is that you have multiple quests lined up for the day. You can pick which one you want to do first and which one you want to do last. So you can do your favorite first or you can do your favorite last. Maybe you don't get a lot of time, so you just do your favorite. And they actually give quite a lot of coins because when you beat the quest, you are not getting a new quest. It just says complete, and when you finish all daily quests of the day, there is no other way to do daily quests anymore. They also implemented weekly solo challenges, which once per week, you can try to defeat a specially customized challenge, which gives you some coins, which is actually pretty cool and a cool concept in general. So the positives about a daily quest system is that of course you get a lot more coins than you would with a rotating system in a shorter amount of time. But the negative would be if you completed all your daily quests, what are you gonna do then? All in all, I don't think one is better than the other. To be honest, I'm actually quite happy with the system that the developers came up with. And the weekly solo challenges, even though we haven't really seen much of it yet, they seem pretty interesting and cool. If there was one little complaint I have to give about the weekly challenges, it's that the reward that they have shown right now, 70 coins, seem a little bit low for a weekly challenge, and I would like to see it bumped up a little bit. But once again, we have no idea how it works. Maybe you can complete the weekly challenge a lot of times. Maybe the reward scales depending on how difficult it is. We have no idea. What I do want to talk about is the daily quests. So what we know right now from the screenshot is we will get 3 daily quests. 3. In this example, it is beating a map without taking damage, killing 50 mushrooms, and beating a map within 10 minutes. All reasonable, and they all give 50 coins. 50 coins might not sound like a lot. 50 coins is huge. Oh my god, this is insane. So, you get 150 coins per day, excluding the coins you get from beating the maps. you get 1050 coins in the week, not including the weekly challenge. If you want to include this weekly challenge, that would give you 1120 coins from just doing quests. We haven't taken into account beating maps, we haven't taken into account buying coins, even though you shouldn't. So that's insane and amazing. I think this update is one that's really needed, because at this moment in time, replayability for Tower Heroes is at an all-time low. And I just love that the developers seen that, they jump on it, they recognize, okay, players want quests, they develop it, and it's gonna come out next update. That's just insane. I just love the fact that the developers recognize the problem, figure out how to fix it, and now they're gonna do something about it. And for me, that's all I ask for. So, at the end of the day, I'm really happy with this decision. I'm wondering how the weekly challenges will work, because right now, okay, this is the most interesting feature I see on this, because it's so mysterious. We have no idea if you can replay it a lot. We have no idea if the reward is going to scale with the difficulty. It's super exciting, and I can't wait to play that. All in all, even though it wasn't my quest system that got added, I am super excited for this update, and I feel like this is going to change the dynamic of how we play Tower Heroes a lot. And as somebody that studies game development, it's super exciting to see how the game will change around this system. Anyway, I can't wait to see how this will turn out. And I would love to hear your guys' opinions on daily quests and the solo weekly challenge. But anyway guys, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.